Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be. Not with me, can't you see? That I am just as embarrassed as you, and I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy. I confess it, I'm shy. Guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear 'cause I'm shy. And you may be sure, way down deep I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it, at bottom I'm quiet and pure. I'm aware that it's wrong to be meek as I am. My chances may pass me by, I pretend to be strong. But as weak as I am, all I can do is try. God knows I try, though I'm frightened and shy. And despite the impression I give, I confess that I'm living a lie. Because I'm actually terribly timid and horribly shy. Though a lady may be dripping with glamour, as often as not she may stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. And she's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a pair of pants. Quite often the lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams. I'm going fishing for a mate. I'm gonna look in every brook. But how much longer must I wait with bated breath and a hook?
Enough that I don't think about the fact that I buried my dad yesterday.
Sam,
that That is what I have to lose. So no, I won't go running through London. I won't dance until dawn, and I won't run off to America because you end up starstruck in a station or on a rooftop with your mouth open, looking at the world, and it feels amazing. Feels like everything is possible, and it feels like just believing that, just feeling that in your stomach is enough. But it's not enough. It's necessary, but it's not enough, because eventually you have to close your mouth, stop staring, get off the rooftop and go to work, and that is what you have to believe in. You have to believe in getting up at dawn, and you have to believe in 14-hour shifts, and you have to believe that being alone is okay, and you have to believe that that shitty magazine job might just lead you to somewhere else. Rooftops? Stars? Midnight runs? They'll just make it harder to get up in the morning. That doesn't mean that I'm giving up. I am not giving up. I'm just getting started.
Dear anyone, I'm writing to tell you about the me you think you know. The me that you've seen grow, that's been putting on a show. You've seen me playing different characters. I've been wanting to tell you for a while. I just want to smile. I'm not the boy you've known from birth. I've grown since then, I've found my worth. This is me, I'm coming out. I tried for years and I just want to shout. I stand in front of you, tall and proud. And I know sometimes I may seem a little loud. You knew I was different from a tender young age. I found my voice and I found my stage. And maybe through this note, you can see me as the woman I am. Adapting to these changes is hard. You might feel like you're losing a son, but hey, you've gained a daughter now. Just promise me you'll try your best and take an oath to accept me as this woman that I am. As I am, I stand. And I know sometimes I may seem a little loud. You knew I was different from a tender young age. I found my voice and I found my stage. And maybe through this note, you can see me as the woman I am.
Me. I was always a ragamuffin in school.
I was gonna start wearing makeup so for once I could get called buff, but then I came to the realization that I was never gonna be good enough for the eyes of him or the likes of her, because it was deeper than that. They didn't value me. Insecurities will eat you up and away, and it's a ball game we didn't even realize we play. Low self-esteem is a dangerous disease that will drag you to your knees, because you'll never be able to please the star on TV or the model in a magazine that doesn't know you exist. Yet we still ride to die as this fabricated creation to please Adam's eye. Eve was made naked. No makeup. No weave. These things are to enhance, yet they seem to deceive. We are shy, for why? We are scared of what? We are hiding from who if I'm the same as you? Our mums always said we must over-oil, because this Britain isn't made for us. Yet this Britain was paved by us. Leave out seeping through the pavements, yet waiting to be straightened by those who hold frustrations and assimilations instead of celebrating integration. Your tones to them are on a palette near a tanning bed. And your lips, they're paying grands for. And your back, don't let them shame you for that. Because in this Britain, they'll try and play you for that. Try to tell you, you have to shake a bit of dirt. But baby girl, don't ever let them sexualize your black. Because in the same breath, they'll conceptualize your black to make appropriated crap. And you're too lit for all of that. I know that black has its own magic. But on this land, it seems to be cursed. How do we teach our kids that even when they've done no wrong, their rights may still be denied? Teach our young that their black is magic, but it's also a crime. Tell them to act right and be polite. And always keep your hands where they can see them, because the moment the police have seen your pigments, you've already given enough reason. And Lord have mercy, how do we teach our girls to be strong instead of scared? Teach them that the love they give is a direct reflection of the love that should live within. How on earth are we going to teach our kids about the power of their skin? Dealing with racism from primary school to university times. Old school teachers with prehistoric ideas of every black child. Microaggressions in the workplace like, what does your hair feel like? Social housing structures aimed to perpetuate black on black crime. We are more than these guys. Working twice as hard for half the pay. Swerving abuse with this smile on our face. Know your worth. And don't be ashamed to say you're a queen. A king of kings made us. So what are we, if not part of a royal family?
I'm sorry. I hate cream eggs. I used to love them. I used to adore them. I used to bite the top off and then like lick all the gorgeous goo from the inside and try and eat the chocolate egg part in one bite. But now I can't. Now I can't even look at one without it sending my whole world into a downward spiral that usually ends up with me dry heaving into a bin or a toilet. Or one time it happened in an alleyway and the pedestrians kept like sidestepping to get around me, giving me that look that I was a hungover 20 something year old who had made poor life decisions to get herself there, which isn't not true, but this isn't one of those times. This is because of that cream egg. And I can see it in your eyes. You're trying to decide whether you should come up with some bullshit fake emergency excuse to leave. But I don't want you to. I want you to stay. I was pregnant when I was 22. It was obviously not planned, and long story short, I lost it. God, I fucking hate that saying, lost it. Like, lost it where? It's not a bunch of freaking keys that are gonna turn up in your fruit bowl. It's not lost, it's just gone. And I remember looking down at the plastic stick and my hands sort of smelt like urine, and I remember wishing for a miracle or a free get out of jail card. I mean, what kind of woman wishes for a miscarriage? And the day it happened, I came out of the hospital and I remember everything was too bright. And I was like looking up into the sky, trying to figure out why this was. And I heard something crack underneath my foot. And I looked down and there was a cream egg, still half in its purple tinfoil and the other half like spewing out onto the grey pavement. And I didn't want this baby. I really didn't want it, but it was gonna be my choice. I was gonna get to decide. And now, every time I see a cream egg, I can't breathe and my whole world stops and starts at the same time, and I get this overwhelming feeling of just guilt, and I ache in places that I didn't even know my body could ache in. That's what I wanted to say to my Tinder date, who was now standing there staring at me, handing me a cream egg as a cute first date gesture. But instead I said this. God, I don't know what just came over me. I must be still hungover from last night. I think I'll have to pass you up on that cream egg.